He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Okay, let's take a look at a couple questions regarding enthalpy of formation. So the first question is just about the definition, where it's asking which reaction defines the standard enthalpy of formation. So we have some options here, and only one of them is going to appropriately represent the definition of the standard heat of formation. So there's a very specific set of criteria that go along with standard heat of formation, and only one of these complies with that. So that's the first question. And so the second question asks, if the standard heats of formation for carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and water vapor are -393.5, -110.5, and -241.8 kilojoules per mole, respectively, what is the standard enthalpy change for the following reaction? So we're going to use standard heats of formation to calculate delta H, or the enthalpy change for this reaction. So if you don't remember how to do this, I have a few tutorials that can help refresh your memory, and when you're ready, give it a try. So looking at this first one, let's refresh our memories as to the definition of the standard heat of formation. The first thing we have to remember is that the reactants must be elements in their most common form, the most common allotrope of that element. So elements can come in different allotropes. It has to be the most common one, and it certainly must be an element. We cannot have any compounds as a reactant. That would defy the definition of the heat of formation. We're forming some compound from its constituent elements in their most common form. And then the second thing is that we are specifically forming one mole of the product in question. It is a situation where we are trying to get a per mole value for enthalpy data regarding the formation of one mole of a compound. So these are the two things that must be kept in mind as we're looking at these. So looking at option A, what do we notice? Well, we see that carbon is in the diamond allotrope, and the problem is that diamond is not the standard state of carbon. It is not the most common allotrope of carbon. We would expect to see charcoal there. So this one is actually not going to work because of the word diamond there. That doesn't comply with the definition. Now, skipping over to option D, we can very clearly see that we have a compound as a reactant. We have carbon monoxide. That is not an element, so this does not qualify as a standard heat of formation for carbon dioxide. This would have to be something closer to option A, just with charcoal instead of diamond, because we need the elements on the left side. Now, looking at option C, this looks pretty good, but the only problem is that on the right, we are forming 2 moles of ammonia. So if we cut all the coefficients in half, and we had 1/2 N2 plus 3/2 H2 yields NH3, then that would be good. We'd be solid, but we don't. We have 2 moles of ammonia on the right, and so that doesn't work. And that leaves option B, and option B is solid because we have hydrogen as an element, we have fluorine as an element, and we are forming 1 mole of HF gas. And so that one works, and so B is the answer there. Now for number 2, we're looking at this reaction, and we want to find the delta H of this reaction, and we have heat of formation data. So we should recall that we can get the delta H of the reaction by taking the sum of the heats of formations of the products and subtracting from that the sum of the heats of formation of the reactants. And so all we have to do is plug in the values that we have. So plugging in the products first, we have -110.5 for carbon monoxide, and we have -241.8 for the water vapor. And so adding those up will represent the sum of the heats of formation of the products. Now subtracting from that the heats of formation of the reactants, we have -393.5 for CO2, and then hydrogen, as with any other element, is going to be 0. Remember, we don't have heats of formation for elements. Elements are what we use as reactants in heats of formation reactions to generate compounds. So any element is going to always be 0. And so we just plug that into the calculator, do the arithmetic, and we get a delta H value of 41.2 kilojoules per mole. So that's a little bit of information about heats of formation.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.